Down, little heat training.
Let's go! Let's go!
We're a bandit.
Wait, how do you know that?
I have no idea. Maybe you saw me on the YouTube.
Oh, maybe.
Workout is 10 miles, 8 to 10 miles. We'll see what's probably going to be my race pace for the trials. So I'm gonna start out around 6:20s, and if I'm feeling good, work it down to 6:10s, maybe the last couple at 6 flat, but this should be like a race effort. I'll try to keep these two layers on to do some heat stimulation, but probably keep the warm up pretty short, do like maybe 2 miles, hit the workout loop, and then I'll see where I'm at. Now we're 9 days out, so it's a little bit of like cramming, but hopefully I can do it in the race. I'd rather have a slightly better workout and slightly less heat training.
It's been the laundry, like, and not even doing the laundry, it's carrying the clothes home in my bag. I'm just like, this is so gross. I'm like piling in just like sweaty long sleeve, sweaty leggings after sweaty leggings, and it's just like, all right, enough. I'm just so looking forward to like the day in, let's say, March or April, where I can go for a run in shorts and a long sleeve. That is perfect, and I don't have to heat train, and I can just jog and be comfortable.
I feel like it's like the Brendan Martin classic last big workout before marathon. Yeah, it'll be 8 mile tempo at marathon-ish pace. I'm feeling good. I think, you know, this past year has been a bit tumultuous in terms of like actual training and running. I've just been going through a lot of injuries. So this build in itself, I've been relatively healthy, which I think has just been like, know that I'll probably be able to step up to the race in Orlando. So we'll see how this feels. I'm sure I'll feel like a little bit rusty, but that's okay.
Dartmouth College, was on the cross country and track team there. Moving here, I mean, I don't think anyone moves to New York thinking like, this is where I'm gonna really pursue running. I felt, I don't know, like a real sense of loss at the end of my senior year of college, like that I wasn't gonna be competing anymore, or that I didn't know what that would look like. After our season was over, two of my friends on the team did the Vermont City Marathon in Burlington, and watching that was like, so eye-opening. Of course I knew marathons existed, but like seeing that race, it was like, this is the next thing. Like, this is such a cool world that like I want to dip my toes into. I remember talking to a friend, like, I don't know how these women are running like 6:15 pace for, you know, almost 3 hours. I don't know. When I was in that race, it just felt like this is much more so than like the 5K or 10K ever did. It was like, this is actually, I think, what I'm sort of meant to be doing in running. The Olympic trials, obviously, for 2020 had long passed. It was like, this was the end of 2021. Yeah, I didn't get it in 22, but seeing Erin do it was amazing. Training with Jean, Leanne, and Erin that summer was great. And I got pretty close. I think I ran like 2:38 high. So it was like, okay, this is in striking distance in 22. I think I knew that I didn't want to do another marathon for another year, basically. I was like, I'm either gonna do Chicago or Berlin. I don't know. I just had this sort of like, one shot, one kill. I kind of had that in my mind, like, this is what I'm doing for the next 3 months.
I think the warm-up can always be a bit deceptive. Like, if you feel good, then that's not always a good indicator for me sometimes.
It means nothing.
Houston was my first marathon. I ran it in 2020, and it was a bit of already like a funky situation where I had graduated from Columbia in 2019, spent the majority of like the latter half of 2019 just kind of running for fun, joining Brooklyn Trot Club, like joining in on those workouts and long runs. That was like during the wave where a lot of women were trying to qualify for the Olympic trials, with the standard being 2:45. And so I was kind of in a position where I thought maybe I could do that. That would be so cool. So very last minute, signed up for Houston Marathon, which was the last day to qualify, because I'd never run a marathon before, and I also like had never run a half marathon or like anything close to that distance. I didn't have a time to back up what I thought I could run. And so I was put in the second corral, ended up running just under 2:43. So when I saw that time on my watch, I was like, you know, ecstatic that I had qualified. And then come to find out that because of the gun time versus chip time rule, my gun time was 2:55 or something that was way above the standard at the time. And so USATF did not allow that time to qualify for the 2020 trials. So then leading into Berlin, USATF ended up changing that rule where just for women, they allowed the chip time to qualify them for the trials instead of just gun time. Across the finish line, I think it was like, it was over 2:37 for the gun time. It was like 2:37:30 or something, because I had, again, was in the second corral starting in Berlin. So if that rule had still been in place, I would not have qualified for 2024 trials.
I've been really lucky. Like, I never had any injuries until this that like knocked me out to this extent beyond like take a couple days off and like ice. So I feel like more than physical toll, it's just like mentally, emotionally, like taking this time off, especially with this like major race just like looming on the horizon. I don't know, there was a long time where I was like, there's no way that I'm gonna get on the line. You know, it's running a marathon 4 months after running a big PR and like accomplishing this goal to turning around and like just keeping building in like a perfect way. Stay locked in. I mean, it sounds cheesy, but like gratitude of just like being able to be in that position that I can get into that grindy mindset. And it's like, and I think it's different. Like last summer when I was training for Berlin, super locked in, it was like, wow, I'm doing workouts that I've never been able to do before at faster paces. And this has been a different experience, but I think coming back from the injury, it's been really nice to just have like, okay, I'm here, I'm able to do this, and let me see where I can take it on the given day.
You know, you just did your first workout, like first quality day back. Your goal for tomorrow is run 20 to 50 minutes, see what your body's giving you. If that, you know, IT bends had it after 20 minutes, call it then, take your ball and go home. And so a lot of ranges, you know, for her, and then getting a lot of her feedback on what she feels like feels good, what feels more challenging, and, you know, kind of leveraging what we can in order to get her doing as much as she can to prepare without, you know, jeopardizing her, you know, injury coming back. You know, first and foremost, I want her to make it as far into the race as she can, taking what her body's giving her on that day and having no regrets about how it goes, and just being happy that she made it to the race and gets to run. She finishes awesome. She just finished her first Olympic trials, and she's gonna do better next time.
Stuck to the lower end of the range, but just like too close to the race to beat yourself up. So started feeling hard on the back hills. My first continuous real marathon workout. And last, there we go. I mean, yeah, at Christmas I couldn't run. I was doing like 3x10 jog, 2 minute walk. So I'll take what I can get.
Workouts that prepare you for the middle of a marathon. When I got into the race in Berlin, I was like, I've been here. You know, like this is where I've lived all summer, like in this mode. Story about Berlin is I actually had like really, I kept looking at my watch and being like, was it sub 2:37? Was it sub 2:36? Like, what's the standard? You know, like, I don't think, did I do it? Like, I don't know, it was really surreal. So I think 173, you might know better than me, 173 women qualified. I think if I'm in the top 100, that would be great. Like, that would be amazing. I mean, yeah, I think it'd be cool to be like, I'm in the top 100 marathoners in the US to focus on time, I think. But if I can like hawk some people down the last 10K.
She just makes some really smart choices and runs tough at the end. Who knows? She could finish in the top half of the field. She could run out of her skin and get top 50. We don't know. You know, Erin's a super talent. She got the trial standard on her first shot at Berlin in 22. Had a tough last year working through a couple injuries, but she's had an amazing block right now. I'm super excited to see how she does.
As both a PT and a coach, and someone who gets injured as well, he understands just how mentally draining injuries can be. And I tend to be very injury prone. And so like leaning into this build, my main goal was like, I just want to be healthy. I want to get to the starting line in Orlando healthy. I want to run the entire race healthy. And then I want to like walk away feeling healthy. Like that's all I wanted, just given this past year. And then we get to go to Disneyland after.
No, I didn't bring water. That's okay. Who needs water?
No hydration.
I'm really sweaty. I feel like through like all this heat training, anytime that I stop, I'm like immediately shivering because all the sweat dries and it makes me really cold. I've got this jacket, a long sleeve, and then this long sleeve, which is very warm.
Let's go!
Funny. Yeah, I thought it was pretty good. That was a good last like hard effort. I feel like I'm so used to Central at this point that like this was not bad. Like usually during like peak tourist season, you know, like in the summer, spring, it gets really bad. If it's like a nice day, everyone decides to come outside and you can like hardly run. But this was not too bad.
Yeah, I just want to be able to look back on it and be like, wow, that was so cool that I got to do that. Instead of putting the pressure on myself of like, I should PR or, you know, try and get this place or whatever. Lily, I train with or have been training with for several years now, and she's like one of my closest friends. So I think it's so fun to get to share the experience, even if like kind of from afar, because we're all a bit in our different place running wise. Like, I'm so, you know, impressed and excited that Lily is like healthy right now and able to get on the starting line. So I think it'll be really great that we can be next to each other there. Yeah, it's fun to bring in the New York energy.
Orlando! Let's do that one time.
All right.
Don't be weird. Your list is not gonna not be weird. La 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 la. Yo, what's the deal? Ain't nothing, Paul. We just here waiting in all that. Yo, one at night, New York City, heard it going down. Friday night, midnight, Atlantic City, slash machines, ding, 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 when they ring off. Lock the doors, that's when ghosts just Cheetos. Cigars, paisley robes, four bitches guarded me safely as we walked to the window. The cashier was scared, she asked.